Welcome back. You're still watching Urban Today. My name is Lynn Komjisha, of course. We were looking at what's happening elsewhere in the world with Vivian Kamsime and Lydia. But now we're back to what's happening in the country. Recently, not very long ago, I think at the start of the new year, the president deployed army to take over the security of Kampala.
Yes, and we saw how that went.
That was quick.
That was quick, yes. But we no, it's that I am very concerned. I know someone who lost a relative during that that riot.
Mm-hmm.
I was very, very, you know how you think something is far?
Right.
And the relative was, she had actually gone shopping in the city center and got shot by a stray bullet.
So that
has been very fearful for the family. Remember, she was like, I can't believe this is happening. These are things that you read about other people. I was like, wow, this is really bad. But yeah.
Right. Okay, so the army has taken over security of Kampala, led by Major General Kayanja Muhanga as the new coordinator of joint security operations within the Kampala metropolitan area. Now, this is a general who is 56 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And you guys, the president yesterday did explain why, yeah? This is why he explains why we're going to look at how what he meant by or what why he deployed the army. But the appointment thrusts Muhanga at the center of all police, military, and intelligence operations in the city.
Mm-hmm.
So everything security, intelligence is going to go through him.
Yes.
And he reports directly
to the president,
the commander in chief,
who is the president. And we are seeing, because we one thing that we have to admit, even if some people are really against having the army in the city, the police just doesn't have the capacity. It doesn't have the capacity. We need all the hands that we can get to actually be in the city, if indeed there is chaos, because some
Absolutely.
People say, no, it's political.
Mm.
Come on, we don't know what's happening in the background.
Mm.
Maybe indeed there could be chaos, and
mm-hmm.
believe me, we are going to need the security operatives to be able to secure the city. Many of us live within Kampala.
That's true.
Yes,
that's
so
true.
That's
so
very important.
Now, their bases that they have created in the city center,
mm-hmm.
One is at around Clock Tower on Entebbe
mm-hmm.
Road, that is going to help in the coordination of city operations. Yes. Now, let's hear from the president on these appointments.
Be bali ababade berimba ntibashobora kukozesa violence mu Rwanda mu kyusotya
obukambwe wakitibwa
obukambwe. Okay. Okozesa obukambwe
obefujjo.
Okose fujo, ndoze fujo chekitufu. Okose fujo, okutisa tisa wana Uganda. Kwanga batisa tisa. Mwabara bawa nubambla, aba inaremu, babambla, ibi ambaru. Mwabara bawa. Ukwambla umuna Uganda, ichambaru. Kwanga yamba de yellow. Okubakuba. Okulumba, barumbe nyumba ya full figure. Full figure ya ne nyumba, ne duka. Aba kulibi wani, kuruachi. Kwachi abantu tebavumirira waliwo obunanfusawo kati amaje gaze kukuma kulaba nti waliwo alumba munne.
Right, that's the president yesterday speaking to journalists from here at the New Vision, of course, led by the editor-in-chief, and they were discussing why he has deployed a military in,
yes.
in the city,
mm-hmm.
and he was giving explanations. Before we get into the explanation, you can join in the conversation. I know you're worried, I know you're confused.
Yes,
you know, you're probably saying, what is all this?
Yes.
So call us on 0414337872. That is the number on your screen. You call us and let us know what your questions or your comment is on,
mm-hmm.
on the latest development.
Yeah,
but
and I know that it's very important that the president came out to explain this, because, and indeed, people are really concerned. I know my family is concerned. I've told you some of my family members have actually set off to Gulu District to just protect themselves in case there is chaos.
Right.
So there's actually real concern. And
mm-hmm.
they are also wondering, will this happen because security operatives are in the city,
mm-hmm.
or are they here to protect? So it's very important to hear the president explain this, and this story is really in detail. you might want to
you
take
know,
a look at.
Oftentimes, the public seems to think presence of the military is a sign of intimidation,
a
sign of the state having, you know, huge authority on the public and their freedoms.
Mm-hmm.
But I think we have seen that there's reason to worry ahead of the general elections.
Yes.
We have seen violence, of course, take place. And the
mm-hmm.
president here was explaining that he has information, he has intelligence information that people are planning to ban Kampala.
Okay.
Please, get yourself a copy of the New Vision, get these details.
And
okay?
You see, Lynn, it's something that you would understand because the army usually does. It's not normal for the army to be walking the streets.
Absolutely.
When you look at the army, you imagine war. They are protecting people.
True.
They
That's
are fighting
true.
In Somalia. They are fighting in South Sudan.
Mm-hmm.
You know, stuff like that. But
mm-hmm.
to see the army in the city, yes, it brings a lot of intimidation. But like we've also seen, you know, the past couple of months, this election is particularly unique.
Very
it's not
unique.
Like just any other election.
Mm-hmm.
We've already seen a taste of what could happen.
Oh,
I mean,
yeah.
I followed Ghetto TV as well, and I saw a few things that were going on there, which were an exaggeration of what was going on in the city. We saw certain police officers being attacked while on the street. We saw that happening as well.
Mm.
And shortly after that, the army was deployed. And I remember it was said that at that point, the police was overwhelmed. They could not deal with the hooligans who had poured on the street, taking advantage of the situation, intimidating people who were driving, asking them for money, burning tires in the city. That was enough to intimidate people. And some people actually slept in their offices. They couldn't go home.
Yes.
So imagine a situation where we have elections and this kind of chaos, you know, flares up again.
On
we are
Thursday,
going to need the army to be in the city. That
Lydia, on Thursday last week,
yes,
I happened to go to town. And there were reports, well, the people I was talking to, like, yesterday we did not work.
Wow.
That was Wednesday last week.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was chaos. The people were scared they were going to be, you know, they closed business downtown Kampala. People were scared that, you know, riots were going to, you know, come back because of what had happened in Kalangala at that
mm-hmm.
time. So it is a very interesting development. So the president continues to say that this is to protect citizens from well-orchestrated plans of violence by certain actors. He said in the past has been the police dealing with wananchi until November 18th.
Mm-hmm.
Do we know what happened on November 18th? Do we remember?
Do we remember
yes.
what happened November 18th?
The riots in town.
Yes. And that was, it caused a lot of fear. And like
Absolutely.
We were saying earlier, it's not just the rioters who are shot.
Mm-hmm.
There are those who are passing by. You know,
mm-hmm.
you go shopping on any day. Like, most of us didn't know anything like this would happen. I remember coming to the office and someone telling me, do you know what has happened?
Mm-hmm.
I told them, no, I didn't know. Like,
mm-hmm.
it's chaos in town.
Yes.
And that's because this thing can flare up at any time. It may not even just be on election day, just any time. And that is why we need security. We need the army to be within. We need
Absolutely.
Whether plain clothes, whether in uniforms, because we have businesses. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people think Kampala is a very huge, huge city. It is not. People are just trying to, you know, put food on the table. They're doing their businesses. So if we have a situation where buildings are burnt down and things are stolen,
we surely don't want to get there.
No, we don't want
we
to
don't
get there.
Want.
We don't want to get there. Yeah.
Right. So the president has appointed, Major General Kayanja Muhanga. He's 56 years old, and they're saying he is quiet but very resolute.
But why does his age matter a lot?
I know it's procedure, I think.
Yeah.
So he was also a one-time commander of the UPDF 2nd Division in Mbarara, which is responsible for security all over Western Uganda.
Mm-hmm.
He also served as task force commander of Ugandan forces in Southern Sudan.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
so this is a seasoned commander.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And it is also reported that before his appointment recently, he was from some other course down in South Africa. So, yeah, he's a seasoned soldier. He's a seasoned intelligence person. So we have somebody that we can trust with our lives, hopefully.
Yes.
Yeah, people have worries. You
well,
know?
They are professional. These people are professional. I hope we can see this because it... You know, what happened in November during the riots,
yeah.
it took us a bit back. You
yeah.
know, it brought fear because You see, the relationship between the people and the army, we should be able to respect these people and know they're here to protect us. And that fear came in.
Mm-hmm.
So we are hoping the way they handle themselves henceforth
is
going to bring that trust to know that these guys are here to protect the peace. They are the army. They are professional. We can trust that if any chaos goes on, they'll be able to handle it professionally, make arrests where there needs to be.
Yeah.
And that people who are loitering around, maybe town or going to do whatever it is they're doing, will not just be shot.
That's very true.
So that's what we hope is going to happen. We hope they handle it better. Actually, we're waiting to see how they handle themselves.
That's very right. Now, 0414-337-8720 is the number to call us on. You might have a question, you might have a comment,
and yes.
Probably you're like Lydia, worried about all this development. Me, I'm not worried because I have some trust in our government, and most importantly in the army. All right, now also relatedly, there's a new traffic chief. All right, there's a call online. Hello, good morning. Hello, Urban Today. All right, you can call us again on 0414-337-872. That's the number to call. Sorry, we lost you there. 0414-337-872. Relatedly, there's a new traffic chief.
Yes.
So the former Kampala Metropolitan Head of Traffic, Lawrence Nwabine, if you remember him, he's back as Acting Director of Traffic Police, replacing Basil Mugisha. A source in the police say Mugisha was asked to hand over after being accused of failure to control traffic issues.
This has happened. I find it interesting that these days we have a lot of interest in police and their personal lives and what goes on. You remember Norman Musinga?
Uh-huh.
He was around and something also happened. He had to be shifted.
It was actually a personal thing.
Personal stuff. So these days we're really interested in what goes on.
No, but I think it speaks volumes of how the relationship between security agencies and civilians.
And the people, yes. It's going now. You know, people are more interested in them. Those days we just ignore.
We have a caller later. Hello, Urban Today.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, and the person's off again. I think it was a woman's voice.
Hello, Urban Today.
Habari Muzuri.
Muzuri.
Moroto.
Wanji.
Hi.
You're calling from Moroto?
Hello.
Hello, your name, please, and where you're calling from?
Hello.
Yes,
hello.
Please, we can hear you.
Hello, your name, please, where you're calling from?
Oh, Moroto.
Okay, Michael from Moroto. Please turn the volume of your TV down.
We can hear you, Michael. What's your question? Nini? Hello, Michael? Unatembea kwa Kampala kufanya nini?
Unajua piga watu roho.
Michael, tunaongea Kiswahili kidogo sana.
Michael?
Unajua lugha ya Kizungu? English? Oh, Michael.
No.
How do we speak to you, Michael? Our Kiswahili is very limited. I hope he's not pulling a prank on us. Come on, Michael.
All right. Okay. We need to go for lessons.
We need to go for lessons. I mean,
but at least you're better than me.
Yeah, because I grew up in the prison's barracks because my dad is an askari, actually. He's a prison's askari. So I grew up there and I speak a bit of Kiswahili. But you know the kind of
Kiswahili. I think we have another caller. Hello, Urban Today.
Hello.
Good morning. Your name and where you're calling from?
Benjamin
Mubende. What do you have to tell us this morning?
Museveni has taken most of our land here in Mubende.
Museveni himself?
Mhozi and Museveni. Many people have been displaced from their land.
Are you sure he's not being accused of taking that land? Some people actually...
How can we protect our future even when you're not on our land?
Okay. All right, Benjamin.
Thank you for your call, Benjamin.
Wow.
Those are serious allegations. And you see, it was said recently that some people go and evict people from land in the name of the president or the first family, and people actually, because they know in the name of the president you're getting off this land, and some people actually believe that's what's happening. But I mean, you can't know what is going on there. But yeah, wow
interesting developments there.
Interesting. I now, don't think we are the ones to answer.
Also yesterday the president did comment on the alleged and actually he says he has intelligence information on people intimidating voters, mm-hmm. and also kidnappers. Okay, so he's saying that the people, they are criminals, they are kidnappers, they are, yes. people intimidating others,
yes.
ahead of the general elections. And he did say a few things, so let's listen to him.
Abarwanyi, Chemba Gamba, Chewa Womu Takutisa Tisa. Era Anakutisa Tisa, Mulope. Nga Bevando Pereyo Maokota, Mbariba Tisa Tisa Bantu. Kati zindi sewa ntu okweke ninya. Kati mulonde tunyweze dembe yafe.
Ah, there you have it.
Mm-hmm.
So actually, it's not only in the city. It's not only in Kampala
city.
No,
it's not. It's
he
not.
Did mention after the death of Zebra Senyange, a renowned boxer, that because of what happened, the riots and the intimidation that has been going around,
yes.
he did send out some security intelligence officers
to go
out
and
there.
Just see what's
exactly.
happening.
Exactly. Yes. So now he has re-echoed the fact that he sent out people.
Yeah, and also there's been a question, speaking of people being kidnapped, there are rumors that people, we also ran a story in the New Vision,
ah, yes.
that people are being picked up and uh-huh. they are disappearing. And you've got families who are asking, where are our people? My
yes.
dad was picked up, my brother was picked up, my son was picked up. In
That's
Entebbe
true.
Here only,
That's
they're
true.
Saying people are disappearing up in the north as well.
Yeah.
So that is something that, yeah, it's very good that he addressed that. And we hope we are going to get answers, because families are actually looking for their
and
people.
And
to know why. Why are people being picked?
And
who
know,
is picking them?
What is bothering me is that we do not know who is kidnapping these
exactly,
people.
We
but
don't.
People are pointing fingers at the government,
yes.
at the state.
Yes.
And this
yes.
is something we need cleared. Not that we have the capacity to clear it, but the president coming forward is him reassuring us that, come on, we are not the ones, dealing with
this
thing.
It's
but
hard
we
to,
are. We want to secure your lives. We want to make
yeah.
sure there's no further kidnaps. There's no, intimidation.
Well,
and
I think there is reason. I would have reason to believe maybe the state is picking up people for whatever reasons. We've seen people
it's
picked
possible.
Up sometimes, and then you find out a week later, maybe the army or the police admitting, oh, we picked up this person to help with these investigations. We also saw the issue of Zebra.
Mm.
Zebra was shot, and all along we thought it was just some random people. And now
yeah.
we know it was security that
security
did
was
also,
involved. In
it
a
is
way.
It is the army or security that may have the capacity to pick people and put them somewhere. So maybe something is going on.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe there is a case they are answering. Maybe they are investigating. And sometimes they go quiet about this stuff until they have made headway.
Right.
So we hope maybe they can come up with answers so we know what is going on.
Hopefully. I look forward to a time where we don't have to question who, to point fingers
yes,
at who.
Yes, that
and,
would be
and,
really
and,
good.
And I think it is a concerted effort. So we, you and I have a role to play in all these things. Okay, so the president still made comments on different things. He was also talking about the NRM contributions. But before we can look at the NRM contributions, I want to highlight a couple of them. They're saying what has been achieved. Uganda as a country has had 15, some of the 15 roads funded, of course, by Uganda as a country.
Mm-hmm.
And there we have Mukono, Katosi, Nyenga, Jinja Road. Mukono, I can't read all of them, but these are very wonderful. And he goes on to say that our tax base has improved. In 1986, it was at 5 billion shillings. Currently, 21 trillion.
Which is a very good thing. And it's good to see that we are now able to fund our own development projects. There was a time when 90% of our budget was funded by foreigners. And now it means we've actually grown as a country. We've progressed enough to be able to actually, pay
that's,
for
that's,
some of
that's
our
very
own developments,
true.
Which is very good. Of course, we still partner with, the World Bank and this fund and here. But we actually have this down, and with time, you know, who knows, we might have to,
and you know, Lydia,
do it just by ourselves and be able to develop.
I have over time studied and read into who the president is, and I noticed that he guards our developments jealously.
Mm-hmm.
So when he deploys army and says we are going to secure this country, no one is going to do anything that is going to go against the country, I feel that it is coming from deep within, because he has struggled for this.
Yeah, these are things he has seen. Some of the things he has seen them develop. And
we
then,
were
know.
At zero at some point, and here we are, 21 trillion Uganda shillings. This is very amazing.
That's a lot. And you see, and that's what happens during any kind of chaos, mm-hmm. in any country, even in the U.S. Every time there's some kind of chaos, people begin looting, burning down things. And why are you burning down stuff? If you're here to protest over an idea that you have, some kind of ideology, do the protest and go away. But people will loot, people will burn down things, and that is the biggest concern we have right now as a nation. Yeah.
Okay. Let's hear from the president when he was talking about the achievements so far.
So, Mbagambi nti nze NRM etadde ebinywa ebyenjawulo ebya special category mu Luganda mukyogera mutya
ebyenjawulo sebo
ebyenjawulo
ebyenkizo
ebyenkizo mwemunakikyusa bulungi naye tutaddeko singa mbadde muli nyankona nage nti omuganda ogw'amaani okusooka okulwanyisa endowooza ey'okusosola mu mawanga n'amadiini ne tuteeka essira ku ndowooza ekulembeza okumalawo ebizibu by'abantu kubanga ebizibu by'abantu bifaanagana eyo enjawuka nayaffe n'ebibiina biri ebikadde bonna basomye tewandibaddemu kusasula nze sikiriza kusasuza bonna basome kubanga nze nali njagala bonna basomere obwereere naye bano bagenda ne bateekamu ate okusasuza nze nandyagadde abaana tubaweerere ababanaku abagagga bo balina amasomero gaabaga abagagga bo bagala kusasula bagende basasule eyo naye nze agange agaabanaku era ndina essomero lyange erinatandikayo ekisozi tebasasula Bulera primary school tebasasula n'olwaleero genatandikira UPE n'olwaleero ekyakola naye ganamalala kubanga gali wala nteekamu sente zaabo n'abasome ate ne basasuza ekirala ensawo z'abanaku okuzongeramu esente ate n'okukendeeza obulombolombo kola kino kola kiri kona kiri kola kiri oba okufuna sente ezo singa tukola ebyo ebirala byonna biringa ebikoleddwa kubanga omusingi weeguli naye awalo n'ekyokulwanyisa obuli bw'enguzi ekyo nakyo kizibu.
Welcome back. Yes, that's the president speaking about the achievements so far. And, well, it is commendable, really.
It is
very
commendable. It is commendable.
And,
we've had good years of stability.
Mm-hmm.
That is something that cannot be taken away. And I know there's a lot to criticize.
Of course.
There's a lot to, you know, to point.
It cannot be a clear line, you know.
But mm-hmm. let me tell you something. We have come a long way as a nation. We have had all this time of stability. And when people tell you what was happened during the times before we were born and the times, you know, before that, there was a lot of instability. One government after another and egotistical leaders who are just pulling. I'm not saying the leaders we have are not egotistical right now, but it's a good thing that we have stability. It's really good. Some of us have never seen a situation where we are at war. The most that I have seen chaos was on November 18th. You know, the chaos that happened, I think, in 2000, was it? The last one was I don't remember when. I think the Buganda riots.
Yes.
Kayunga riots. Yeah, that one I was not.
That was 2009.
Yeah, I was not within the city. But the most I have seen is this one because, and I was not within there, but the fear, I could feel that.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember going home and my parent was telling me, my friend, if you knew what happened those days,
mm-hmm.
it was horrible. So we are in a better place and we hope that politics does not divide us in such a way that we are ready to burn down everything.
Right.
We should not be like that. We should Absolutely. Find a way of going forward without burning down the nation.
Talking of burning things down, the president has really, really come forward strongly to say, why are people not condemning the people that are intimidating others?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the army has come to make sure no one attacks anyone. Yes, and he said this, some of these things. Let's listen to him. Okay.
Njagala kubaka kasamwe na bana Uganda. Omusirikare bakuyimiriza yimirira toduka. Bwe bajja awaka oku bwe bakuyita oje mu police station. Oje. Bwe mukwatagana n'amagye tebagenda kuba kabikona. Naye ate bali ababadde beerimba kubanga babadde balina pulaani nti bagenda kutabula tekigenda kubaawo ekyo kyembakakasa tiwaliwo agenda kutabula era anaagezeko yenna agenda kwejjusa so abamagye abasecurity bonna balina okubeera beerufu ekibaawo kubanga tiwaliwo kyakukisa bakuyita kukisa
kituufu nnyo ssebo ekitiibwa
to hide.
Yes.
Even if a mistake has happened, it should be admitted. Even if it is a correct thing, it should be admitted. So I don't agree with this. Okutwala abantu no sirika. No. Say. Erangena kuchimara wecho. Manyi waro kuanga ruri na soma manya. Banga amantu babade nabo. Mbade nabo mkwala china wo. Omutwali mkoti. Bwato mtude mkoti muleke adeyo awaka. Obaba waba asazio okuyamba kukora nawe na butegeza ba family nitu ono. Kata asazio okunyamba mirimo jendiko. Because some of them can help.
Wow. I agree. Wow, I totally agree.
Yeah, that's advice on how to behave when you are faced with, say, a man in uniform.
If they approach you,
and one thing that cooperate. One thing that people in security need to understand, and I do appreciate what the president was saying, but was telling people this is how you behave, this is how you handle yourself when a security officer comes. But you see, for most Ugandans here, we don't know what it's like for someone to point a gun at you. If someone points a gun, people run.
Yes,
people run. So it is hard to just stand there and say, okay, sir, what's going on?
But again, I wouldn't want security operatives to just walk up to me and point a gun at me. I am unarmed.
No,
okay?
The gun is up and you're saying, what do I do?
If I'm unarmed, I expect you to approach me and tell me, so, Lynn, you're in wrong, and we need to, take you for some questions.
Leave alone that they speak in this Kiswahili harsh language, Wewe!
And you just witness. We don't know. Not every Ugandan knows Kiswahili.
Exactly. You freeze or you begin to run. So there's that element of fear.
Yes.
That I hope we can get.
Yeah. I mean, if I have done something, it doesn't matter. You just approach me the right way. Yes. But if you come wedging.
And for me, I don't have anything. So it becomes something. It becomes I know that I have to run for my life.
Pretty much. But yeah. So with this deployment, I just hope that we can be civil, as civil as possible.
Yes.
And I hope we can remain calm.
And on their side, they will be professional.
I really hope
and understand that we are not used to army officers and guns. Even when you just see them walking, people are like, oh my God, what's going on?
Yeah.
Come on. They're actually you and me, but in uniform. They are your everyday people. They are people, someone's sons, they are someone's husband, they are someone's friend.
That's true.
It's just, they're just like you and me, but in uniform. So please.
Yes.
Yeah.
So pretty much, I hope you understand why we have army presence in our city. Those of you in Kampala City, and of course those places he said he received complaints from. So don't you worry, just please be where you're supposed to be at the right time. Do not Yes, my word, gallivant, okay? Don't just gallivant. Right, now as we wind up, of course this conversation, the president yesterday did mention a whole host of different things, and we're going to have to air the full interview on a Vision Group platform that is at Bukede, Etop, that is Bukede Pharma, 7 p.m., Etop Radio, 7 p.m., Red European, 7 p.m., Arua One, 7 p.m., One Luo, 8:30 p.m., Urban TV, 9:30 p.m., TV West, 9:30 p.m., Radio West, 9:30 p.m., Bukede TV One, and Bukede TV Two at 11 p.m., and this is today. So look out and don't miss out on the full interview the president had. But we cannot go without talking about Emioga money.
Exactly.
Yes, and he also talked about it. Mm-hmm. He's saying that he's trying to work around the fact that there's a bureaucracies and cumbersome processes of accessing Emioga money. So he's still working around how we can access this money. But Lydia, assured, will we ever get this money?
I don't know. I know a couple of people I know. Who came together and wrote their names somewhere?
I know, for the Emioga money. Me too.
I know a couple of people. So I'm waiting to see how that goes. I was also asking them, so are you going to pay back this money or...
Who is going to pay back?
Yeah, so their excitement is pay back what money? So it's a happiness thing. I have not registered for the Emioga money.
Why?
I had my reservations. I had a lot of questions which were not being answered, by the person who was trying to encourage me to join it. So I said, let's just let it be.
My biggest problem is one, corruption. The money arrives and some people are just pocketing it from one person, the bureaucracies.
Yes.
So there's a head.
By the time it reaches you.
The head receives, he deducts his, sends to the next, sends to the next. By the time it gets
by
to the
time it
person,
gets to you,
and that, it is literally nothing.
That is the drama I wanted to avoid. I just said, first of all, I don't have the energy to chase for free money, and I don't trust free money. It's just my,
Of course, we don't trust free money. No one would. I wouldn't.
But even
trust
this
free
money, but this is money that's coming, from taxpayers, and I am a taxpayer. But you see, by the time this money reaches you, like Lynn has said,
it
may
gone.
Not be anything. So
Mr.
we are waiting
President,
to see how that happens.
By the way, they've eaten all that money, if you should know. Me, I've reported them. I'm just saying, but I've had these reports around. So please, that is also something we need to look at. Thank you very much for having been part of Urban Today. Lydia and I we're signing out. We need to go and take some breakfast and prepare for the day. But thank you very much. We'll definitely catch you again tomorrow. Stick around. There's more programming going up and going on. But also, wear your mask.
Wash your hands.
Sanitize your surfaces.
And do not gallivant in Lynn's voice. Have a good day.